disease any disease rather that affects a small percentage of the population, or at least one in every 20,000 people. Around the world, patients afflicted with rare diseases face the same challenges, such as lack of information on their condition, social consequences, isolation, and inequities in the availability of treatment and care. The country will mark National Rare Disease Week to help raise public awareness on rare disorders. Now, here to talk about the National Rare Disease Week and their campaign is Cynthia Magdaraog, the president of the Philippine Society for Orphan Disorders Incorporated. Good morning.
Morning, Paolo.
Okay, Pinky already actually started the discussion right before she left. She said, that sounds interesting, orphan disease. Why is it called an orphan disease? Maybe let's set the stage by talking about what exactly are these conditions that we're talking about.
Well, first of all, it's called orphan disease because all over the world, it's the same situation that the government usually does not pay attention to these diseases. Mm-hmm. Very little is done on developing treatment.
Right.
And also the public is not very much aware. Mm-hmm. So these conditions, as you said, are conditions that are only less than one in every 20,000.
Okay, so it's not a specific disease or condition. It's not a one specific disease or condition. It's a variety of diseases, but such a small segment of society are affected.
Yes.
Okay.
And it varies from country to country, mm-hmm. depending on the population.
Right.
Okay.
Is there a condition that can be termed as, I know it's an oxymoron, but the most common rare disease in the Philippines?
No, there are certain diseases that are more in numbers than the others.
Mm-hmm.
No, depending also on the extent of facility in the country to detect this rare disease.
Okay.
Normally, when children are born, mm-hmm. no, they look normal.
Right.
Only in a few days or sometimes years mm-hmm. that the condition, the manifestation comes out.
Okay.
So it is very critical that pediatricians, who are the first ones to see the child, after giving the normal treatment and mm-hmm. still it's not handled or managed, mm-hmm. then they must suspect it could be a rare disease.
A rare disease.
Yes.
Okay. Now, PSOD, or the Philippine Society of Orphan Disorders, has been organized to sort of focus attention on the plight of individuals who don't get covered by the focus of the medical field because it's a rare condition.
Yes.
That they have.
It's hardly covered, mm-hmm. at least not very, almost nil.
Mm-hmm.
And that is one of our campaign
okay.
this year.
Mm-hmm.
No? Just to give you a background, we work hand in hand with the Institute of Human Genetics.
Okay.
These are the geneticists, team of doctors who medically manage, mm-hmm. Diagnose and manage these conditions.
Right.
And before, they used to be the one to look for the funds and help. Mm-hmm. But as the numbers are growing, in 2006, we formed an organization, and this function is given to us mm-hmm. to look for access to treatment, give family support, mm-hmm. And of course, create awareness for
okay.
these children.
Right. So I mean, it's part of it is fundraising. Part of it is getting the information out there to people who
yes,
may
yes.
be affected, and for people to also be aware that there are conditions that aren't, you know, the more common conditions.
Yes.
How is funding? How do you get funding? How is the funding used? What is the biggest goal of the organization?
Well, right now the concern for funding is to access the treatment,
mm-hmm.
and they are very, very expensive because
right.
the treatment is developed usually by biotech companies,
mm-hmm.
no, and this is lifelong.
Right.
Okay. So right now we are very grateful to pharmaceutical companies and biotech companies
mm-hmm.
who provide the treatment on compassionate use.
Right.
Okay. But eventually the country has to share or co-pay. And that's where we are at now, because we have been enjoying compassionate use for mm-hmm. for one enzyme replacement therapy for about since 2003,
mm-hmm.
and for the medical formula provided by a pharmaceutical company
mm-hmm.
as long as 19 years ago up to current.
Mm-hmm.
So these children are able to be saved, and live a very relatively productive life. No? Mm-hmm. So we are now campaigning for the inclusion of this sector by the health program of the government, mm-hmm. especially that this administration, this current government, has pronounced that universal health plan is one of their key program.
Right. Okay, we're actually marking our third National Rare Disease Week. What activities are sort of lined up for this marking of this week?
The biggest activities are awareness, of course, because mm-hmm. we cannot get support without people knowing what we are and what we need. So we have over the past 2 years, we have requested first of all the hospitals and other hospital institutions to put banners mm-hmm. about Rare Disease Week. Mm-hmm. We have also requested the Department of Health to put us in their health calendar, so that their network of regional hospitals are aware and they can campaign for early identification. Mm-hmm. Also, private companies who have been helping us in one way or the other, put them on their website mm-hmm. That they support Rare Disease Week. We do have also programs for families. We feel, by the way, the theme this year is strength, rare, but strong together.
All right.
Okay? And the family, basically the parents, should be the first people to be strong.
Right.
So we have programs for the family on three areas. Mm-hmm. One is a session on how to cope, especially those who have recently gotten the news that they have a rare disease child. No, and second, we also have a medical workshop wherein in joint participation of the College of Nursing, the parents are going to be trained how to do home care skills at home, mm-hmm. because it is very important they know what to do in case of emergency, and how to handle them in various situations. Mm-hmm. The third one also is that we are providing a workshop for personal financing planning, savings, and entrepreneurship.
Absolutely. I mean, that's probably one of the. I mean, next to the first couple of how would you say concerns that a family has is really the financial strain that it takes on the family to deal with these rare conditions.
That's true.
Okay. All right. That's great. If people want to sort of be involved, support, what channels can they go through?
Well, we have our website, www.psod.org.ph. Mm-hmm. Our Facebook, just type Philippine Society for Orphan Disorders, and we have our information there.
All right, so all the information is there, and any help is most definitely welcome.
Oh, yes, yes.
Yeah. All right, well, thank you so much to Cynthia Magdaraog, the president of the Philippine Society for Orphan Disorders Incorporated. Thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much for this opportunity.